Okay, so somehow we actually put the three weights on the daises in that room. That was the most ridiculous section, I think, of any video game I've ever played. We got the sound that triggered the puzzle being solved. I don't see anything different. So I'm heading back to that room. I assume it opened the door. And we won't have to put the weights on the dais again, but we will have to get through the door. I'm just a little bit flabbergasted. In order to do it, every time I went through that room and fell through a platform, I tried to take notes, and I built a little picture showing which platforms are false. I will put that up on the screen at the beginning of next video. And then I just tried different routes. To go through, we were very lucky before, I mean, very unlucky, where we actually hit the lower dais as the third dais, and we fell off screen before the sound sounded. And I'm willing to bet that the developers considered that, and that makes me sad. It kind of killed me. But I didn't give up as much as I wanted to. And here we are. Can do this almost every time. Right, so we expect witches, but not deuses. Oh, thank God it worked. So I'm gonna kill witches because witches be bitches. And that was pretty key. I don't think there's any way that I could have done this with the witches alive. I'm just gonna look at my little map again. I can't put it up on the screen just yet. Like I say, I'll put it up on the next video, but I think we can jump straight across. This is such a tricky room because if you bump your head and you fall, you're kind of screwed. Okay, we have a mini boss. It looks like two of the, honestly, one of the easier bosses from the dimension, in this dimension. I was really hoping for a checkpoint. I'm still amazed that we didn't get a checkpoint 5 screens ago. I should stop and stream this, but I also don't really want to get back to this room, so I'm going to give it a shot. And if it doesn't work, I'll switch. But I really wish I had health. I could always use the Lamp of Time. feel like it's a trap. I feel like everything is a trap. Okay, so what I can do... So this is 31, I think. Oops. So down makes sense. So, like, we have no reason to think that it's a troll other than the fact that this game is trolly. But here we go. Okay, this one sucks, I think. He moves really fast at some point. He's like a moose thing. Whatever. Yeah, this is 32. He's a different okay. All right, so two at a time. This is a little concerning. I feel like I damage boosted to kill him in the real game. I mean, with Caltrops. Did those spikes hit me? Alright, it's no big deal. Haven't had to use the Lamp of Time. That's a shame we don't get the orb. Okay. Is this like a mini boss attack? Okay, so this is 33. So obviously we have to get into that little section somehow. Now, according to the map, this is coming up, yeah. Okay, but I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to keep going until I fail and have to sort of start over. and then I'll stop for now, but let's push on. Yeah, look, this thing to the left, it's not lit. That's where we're going to be walking through, I think. I don't trust that pot. I'm thinking of the inferno where there's a boulder. Look at that. Can't get either of these. Well, I don't want to go down. But I'm gonna test the floor. So I don't see anything. So we fell in from the top right. So my first thought is maybe somehow the enemies are meant to unlock it. Like, all right. Like the bomb slimes, you know, throw bombs. But so far they haven't affected the scenery. The fact that pot drops a chakram is suspicious also. They're relatively rare. And I believe it's dropped it twice, so I'm gonna try that. Alright, this is really crazy, but I'm just gonna walk around and like scan and press down. In case there's a hidden dais. I feel like there's a way to teleport in there now. Oh, okay. I did not expect them to respawn. But the path is still open, so... It's a good way to get health back, I guess. Okay, let's look at the map. Nice. Okay, I have another theory. I'm gonna kill the enemies first. No chakram. Oh, it's in that guy. Okay. So the other thing that I always thought was an unfair puzzle were the pots. So I tried going down it. You can't go down it. Can't scan it. Maybe I shouldn't have killed the one at the bottom. Top of it. I mean, the pots are lined up in the middle, but I don't know. That probably doesn't mean anything. Like, push the pots. Well, now I'm stumped again. To teleport back means that, well, we have to get back here. But now I have I have a strong suspicion that So nothing even gives like a sound that there's a secret. I don't know why I always think that there's an in-game map for this area. So now I'm thinking maybe those daises are supposed to show you where to put them, but you're supposed to put them in another room. But I don't remember any that looked like that. And it's not this one. So now I'm thinking, what if I can get the monkey to hit something? Like, the monkey turns something on. You know, hit the 33 or something. There's three pillars. Wow, there's not even like a cryptic hint that I can mull over. It could be that I have to bring a key fairy here, but the only way I could do that is if there's a checkpoint. I mean, is this the end, or...? Or... I don't even know. It's a little strange that there's no... So there's no way to fall down. So that other might indicate there's no more hills. Or the map's gonna change. I mean, I have no idea. I'm really just kinda talking out loud to maybe hopefully generate some ideas. I like doing this. It's not useful. But it's cool. I'm trying to think, is 33 somehow significant anywhere else in the game? We don't have Reader equipped. I'm gonna... Yeah, but it usually comes up and it gives you garbage. So, I mean, not garbage, but... La-Mulanese. But just in case, I'm gonna equip it. I mean, I don't think so, but... So we expect mini-bosses to respawn. This is the witch room. This is like the easiest of the mini bosses. She doesn't move, she can't attack you through a platform. This is a weird room. Like, what are the mud men for? So as far as I know, we don't have any hints. I would have remembered, I mean. I mean, we've whipped everything, surely. All right, I'm gonna sit here unpaused because we never really understood let the music play, and we don't know how we. No, because that tablet must have been related because it went away. So what if this is symbolic? Maybe it's not in the room above, but maybe there's... Maybe this is meant to be where I'm supposed to go. Problem is, it doesn't really tell me where. I was thinking maybe three. Room three. What was room three? I mean, that's a real stretch. I can't remember. I mean, maybe, but I can't remember a place where there was three pillars. There were certainly pillars that can shrink and grow. So I was gonna quit in order to stream this part, but I know that streaming a puzzle that you're stuck on isn't particularly fascinating. But... I don't know. I feel like I should go back to the Vi room and look for... Look for a checkpoint. Because if I remember right, there's a little alcove in the top right that we never explored, and I thought we'd come back to it, but we haven't. Kills me to quit, I mean, to leave from this point, but I guess we won't have to kill the mini bosses again. I'm gonna try going backwards. So through the witch's room from the right. Not because I think that's gonna unlock anything, but I think it could be easier than doing the platforming again. And I don't really see a reason why not to. Well, okay. Just to make sure we slept. I mean, I'm pretty sure we counted. All right. We still don't really know what's in this tent. I mean, this had something to do with this riddle, and I still don't get it. All I did was sat on the third one, as far as I can tell. Okay, let's do this again. Hopefully. Well, we've certainly gotten better at that. It's sure is a skill. I take some small amount of solace in that. Very small. Because, it's not particularly fun. It's so precise. So I don't know what we're looking for. Well, I don't know, but here we are. But we've never been up there, so like it makes sense to try. Okay. Oh shit! That's right. That was the other reason. There's no There's a ladder. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Okay. We got a little crab dude. Some tablets to read. Let's see how trolly this room is gonna be. Okay. Yeah, that's all it says. Okay, joy. Open. Close. And anger. So the first thing that comes to mind are the mantras. I don't know if they actually mean words, but I think that they do. I was really expecting a checkpoint here. Really? And it's with this hidden room? It's gotta be. Okay, that's not it. Oh, come on. I mean, I'm sure this is an important hint, but I think I would prefer a checkpoint. How could they not give you a checkpoint? What's the point of an enemy that can't hurt you? I feel like that's out of character. Like, if it shot bullets, it would make a lot more sense. Because then you couldn't, it would be difficult to kill it. Okay, what if these tablets actually refer to a puzzle in this room? So I don't know the mantra language. I never really understood the what the mantras are. But there's no harm in trying each one. I mean, it might kill me. So there, I know that there are tablets in the temple of Sun that talk about the mantras. I don't know if they say like what they mean, or if they, you know, maybe I'm just making like it has nothing to do with mantras. They could refer to enemies or something. Oops. Like, joy, like in the other puzzle to figure out the medicine. But I don't, what enemy would represent open? Now I'm thinking, what if I solve this puzzle to get the checkpoint? Joy, open, close, anger. Ah, I want to hear that secret sound. I want to hear rocks crumbling. Joy, open, close, anger. So you open and close a door. open and close is kind of like life and death. Birth and death. Origin. What's the difference in origin and birth? So I think I need to figure out what the meanings of all the mantras are. Because, I mean, there are mantras of birth and life, life and death. Okay, birth and death. So we could go to the Temple of the Sun and read those. I don't have any other ideas, but it seems kind of like a long shot. I really don't want to platform my way back here. So because I've beaten the game and I've read the wiki having to do with the like even how to solve the mantra puzzle to begin with, I'm just going to look up the meanings of those mantras. I mean, maybe they don't even have a meaning. So the first mantra is in the corridor, the entrance to the never-ending corridor. That's the description for Marduk. The second mantra is at the foot of the twins, at the tip of the feet that connect the two. That's Sabbat. But that doesn't really describe what Sabbat is. Like, I know Wedget is an I, and Vi is the... is a boss. La-Mulana is the... temple. There's also tablets that talk about some of the words. So in order to beat the endless corridor puzzle, there's a hint for that, where you have to walk through certain signs in the right order. So birth is 2, life is 3, rebirth is 5, ascension is 9. And I think that tablet is in the Mausoleum of Giants, but I might be mistaken. But it doesn't look like there's one for joy. Okay, so numbers don't mean joy or anger. or close and open for that matter, but close and open could be birth and death, I guess. Oh, give me a checkpoint. So, keys open. But what's joy? Pepper is joy because it's tasty. I have no idea. Oh my god, it kills me that we found this room. I mean, we figured it out from the map. We sort of lucked into it, but... always be whipping. Try every button in every place. It's kind of the strategy. But it kills me that we found the room, and there's... I mean, there's a hint here. Okay, that's cool. But I don't even know what puzzle this is for. So it's a little bit... of a letdown. I would have bet money that there was a checkpoint. There's gotta be another checkpoint, I'm convinced, because the center door goes outside, and then there's space on the left for another door. But what's the point? Okay, so, but still, what's the point of this? Is it just a trap? Just to get you to take some health? God. I had a shield. I don't want to do this platforming again. Come on, give me a checkpoint. come on up here. Joy, anger. Weren't they also associated with gems? Like the onyx and the ruby and the the joyful heart is pearly white. The eloquent heart is black. The sincere heart is purple. The blissful heart is blank. Pure heart is white. The passionate heart is red. And the affectionate heart is blank. I mean, I don't see angry. I certainly don't see open and close, but there is joyful heart as pearly white. There's white witches. The white opal represents joy. Is a tablet in chamber of birth. That's the only thing that seems to. Oops, I keep raindropping here, or whatever you call it, and then I'm not exactly sure what I'm doing, but. If you keep jumping, it brings you to the hill again. So joy is white, but that doesn't really make sense with the other three. A white opal. Yeah, I don't know. And right into this one. So he's white and black. He's joyful. He's angry. I don't know. I'm not even sure why I would go back to either of those rooms, to 29 or to 33, because I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. Oh my god, it's an emotional roller coaster. I was so thrilled to get through the witch room with the daises. And I thought, oh my goodness, now there's gonna be a checkpoint and it's gonna be fun again. But that's not the case. On either count. It kills me that I have to wait here. Also that I have to take damage. I mean, I assume you don't, but... this is how I know how to do it. I think this is too low. God damn it. Oh, thank goodness. It's very, very tight. I want to say maybe 3 or 4 pixels. I mean, at least based on my knowledge. Maybe there's a way you can improve it. You can whip the beam. At least it looks like it. Kind of strange that there's no entrance for the mudman. Like, why not put that little graphic? Hey, the bosses didn't come back. Thank goodness for small favors or whatever. Alright, so obviously the monkey's joy, the wolf slash horse is close, this fellow's open, and this one is anger, and this one doesn't count. That's pretty clear. Okay, through the pot, of course. Goes through floors, might as well go through pots. Kind of made sense. Ah! We've whipped every wall and every floor. But I'm completely out of ideas. So one part of me thinks that the solution is in this room, because almost every puzzle in Hell Temple has had a single room solution. Especially with deuses. Another part of me says we've done everything possible in this room. Thank you. I know my music idea was crazy before, and now it's even crazier. That's kind of like where I'm at. Oh, I thought I had it for a second. I was thinking, what if this ladder continues down? That would be really cute. But it doesn't. Boy, I'm glad I have all this software combinations. Jesus. So now I'm back to thinking maybe it has something to do with the enemies. I mean, we don't have any hints that suggest that, but like I say, I'm kind of out of ideas. Never knowing whether the solution is in another room is makes a puzzle so much harder. Because at this point, oops, I did the little trick. Wish I could master that. Seems to happen a lot in Hell Temple. At this point, the solution could be in literally anywhere in the game. Maybe in a room that I haven't even found. And that's a little overwhelming. To not know when to give up in this room is pretty rough. Like, I've done everything I can think of. I mean, other than literally trying every item. You know? Have some pepper, deuses. So 3 is the number that corresponds to the seal of life. So I'm thinking, let all the monsters live and break the pots, because that's all I know how to do. But that's not it. I'm out of ideas. And I feel like a lot of the ones that we've tried have been kind of stretching it already. I was hoping maybe Zelpud would have some advice. I really am desperate. I feel like if I could just get in there, I could get both of them. All I can think of is a fairy. I mean, maybe there's enough time to get it here, but that is pretty rough. That would be pretty rough. It would put added pressure on what's already a tough platforming section. And I don't even know if you have enough time. Such a weird room. Like, why are the elephants over there on the left? I don't know what to do. I thought we made some exciting progress, and I guess we did. But just like that, we're stuck again. This time on a puzzle instead of a platformer, platforming section. And honestly, I don't know which is worse, because when you're stuck on a platforming section, at least you know, well, I just have to practice this. And eventually I'll get it. And it's pretty rough because, you know, you fail and you have to start over. Being stuck on a puzzle is a whole nother beast. Because what do? Try stuff. Well, okay. That works. For a while. And at some point, the question is, where do I try stuff? Like, maybe the solution to this is go to room 3, or maybe the solution is to go talk to Mulbrook, or, I mean, it could be anything. So I know that by this is how desperate I am. I know that by using the raindrop, you can get into the room below. I have no idea how to do it, but I know that it's happened. Especially when I go up a ladder and there's a wall on the right, it seems to happen. Like it happened here earlier, just like, I don't know. I don't know how long I've been in this room. And it has something to do with grappling and jumping or something. I mean, I know this is not how you're supposed to do the thing, but in some sense, I mean, I'm allowed to do whatever I want. Okay. I thought I saw something, but maybe it was just dust or something. I mean, how he kicks up dust when he turns. But it kind of looked like he went behind something. God, what? Now I'm thinking, what if it's something that is obvious? I mean, it can't be that obvious, but what if it's right here in this room and I go running around? Like, I'm thinking, okay, well, in the game, sometimes you had to go back and talk to Mulbrook. What if I have to go back and talk to Dracolet or Zelpod? I mean, it looks like such a non room. Like, there's nothing interesting other than some daises you can't get to, which is super typical for this game. So to think that it takes something extraordinary maybe is kind of silly. Don't whip anything. Okay. Let me through! I didn't whip anything! I know this room is about life. Alright. Everyone dies. Especially you, monkey. Alright, well, I'm out of ideas. I think I have to think on it. Because I don't know what to do. So I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna stop it here. And thanks for watching.